girl Chlo, and Happy New Year! Today, we're gonna get you to the next level of your career. People have a lot of opinions about getting to your goals in the new year, but if there's ever a time to get your bum off the couch and get you to do stuff in life, it is now. Ride that momentum, make it work for you, and take it to infinity and beyond! I'm sure there's lots of goals this year, like exercise more, eat clean, try to date again if you're up for it. Say yes more, heck, even be a morning person, which I don't know if I'll ever be able to accomplish. But I know why you may be here. You're probably in a rut at work, you might not be super happy, and you wanna make a change happen. Like, let's break through that bamboo or glass ceiling or whatever the heck that is holding your badass potential back, because you know you deserve better. If you don't, I know you deserve better. But no matter where you are in the career, just know that nobody will care for your career except for you. Nobody can own it except you. Don't let career just happen. Because the reality is, your employer only cares about making you work for them as much as possible while giving you as little pay as possible. And if you don't say anything, they think you're fine and they won't do anything. And the only person who loses is you. I graduated from engineering school, didn't do CS, but I took enough STEM classes to get one of the highest engineering awards in my class. I didn't want to be an engineer. I really love the people side of things. And I went from HR to analytics to biz dev to product management. I have learned a lot of tricks along the way to accelerate my career, and I want you to have them. Just like here. But before we get started, let me introduce you to the sponsor that made today's video possible, Bubbles!
I'm Bubbles, and welcome to...
No, that's not the right one.
Bubble Party!
That's not it either.
Introducing Bubbles, the easiest way to collaborate with your team no matter how or when you work.
This pandemic has gotten us working from all kinds of time zones. Last year, I was working from Taiwan and still meeting with my teams in the US, Singapore, Dublin, Beijing. It was nuts. Finding time to meet was like playing calendar Tetris on expert mode. Working from home also means you're juggling all kinds of distractions and you can't always meet right now. So then the world turned to async work, which has a lot of pros. In the future, it's very likely that the best companies will be async first. And that's why Bubbles was born.
Bubbles helps you get even more work done in less time. How it works is that you can record your screen and do a little voiceover or even a whole presentation. The point is, you can express yourself however you want. You can then send your work to your team and they can comment on the recording itself with annotated timestamps. That way you can stay connected with your team without scheduling so many meetings just to catch everyone up. Bubbles makes things really easy and intuitive. I mean, just look at this activity feed, so clean. I see all the latest updates without constant notifications. Oh, and it looks like we've got something for the Chlomunity retreat.
Use my unique link in the description to try out Bubbles for free, or just to show them some love from the Chlomunity to show them that we're cool and that we like getting things done too. Now back to manifesting your best life. For the scope of this video, I'm going to assume that you're entry level or mid industry level and you're just trying to transform, accelerate, advance, fast track, meteorite your career into rapid growth this year. And honestly, for me, changing four different career paths in the short span of my life, I strongly believe that the secret is your relationship with your manager. You need your manager to be your sponsor and propel you forward. As much as you work for them, they are working for you too, and your life shouldn't be a bunch of team meetings and one-on-ones where you just give progress updates. That is a recipe for busy work and no growth whatsoever. Your relationship with your manager can really make or break your career. I worked with over 10 managers full-time, and there are three things that I always talk to them about, and this is all part of what we call a career development conversation. Y'all should be scheduling this like once a quarter or something. But there are three parts to it. The first is the career reflection. For your career reflection, it's about what you do, how it aligns to what you want, what your dreams are, and what prevents you from getting there. Let's talk this out. How do you feel about this role? Is it what you expected? Do you enjoy the day-to-day? What do you do that aligns with your strengths? What do you do that doesn't align with your strengths? And maybe you need to roll that off so your time can be better used elsewhere. What are strengths that you haven't fully utilized yet? Maybe your manager doesn't know how to bring out the best parts of you because they don't know what they are. And if they don't know that, how can they build a good plan for you? I know that jobs don't make up our entire identity, but they shouldn't hold us back from what we're truly capable of. Tell them about what you're most interested in your next growth opportunity. Is it learning new skills, trying new verticals, transferring, getting promoted, becoming a manager? This should get their gears going to come up with a concrete plan with you to get these opportunities and set you up for success in the next 6 months. And then also talk about your working style. Do you enjoy the cross-functional projects or more of the deep dive research projects? This will reveal the day-to-day work that you naturally gravitate towards. And this could be your superpower at work. What project spaces or product areas do you ideally want to work on? Because let me tell you, I'm all about depth over breadth. I just think that being great isn't about being great at everything, but about being great at one thing. And definitely talk about what goals you want to achieve in the next 1 to 3 years. What are you doing? What are you working on? What are you talking about? And phrase this in a really specific way, like I want to achieve XYZ. This can also help your manager gauge whether you will outgrow your role and you need to be on a better track. And it also helps prevent you from staying at one place too long because it no longer serves your goals. And lastly, talk about what barriers or challenges exist that prevent you from achieving all the goals that you want. Because maybe it's a skill gap, and you know what? Your manager can ask the company to get budget to help pay for courses or coaching or conferences, which is really dope. Actually, one of my teammates learned English as her second language, and she was able to get communication coaching paid for, which is so sick. Another thing could be visibility. Maybe you do awesome work, but the right people aren't seeing it. And now your manager can help advocate for you and your work and broadcast it out to all those people who may be your future manager. So that was the career reflection portion. And honestly, sometimes this part can take up like a full hour or an hour and a half. And even though some of the questions might sound really basic, it's only clear in your head, not in your manager's. And that is the point of this conversation. The second thing to talk about is performance. Now, if your company does performance reviews, they usually happen 1 to 2 times a year. It's pretty standard across the board. You have your role, you have your level, and you have competencies. And within those competencies in the level, you have certain expectations. And there's a rating system to assess whether you're hitting the expectations of the competency of your role at that level. Does that make sense? Oftentimes, performance is tied to a bonus, so you make more money if you perform higher. And sometimes it's connected to promotions. But remember, performance and promotion are independent but related pillars. Just because you have amazing performance doesn't mean you're gonna get promoted. But it is critical that you talk to your manager openly about where they assess you and where you assess yourself and where the mismatch is. And you need to do this way before the performance review happens, because far too often, managers kind of punt this conversation until it's too late, and then you get your rating and you're surprised and maybe even frustrated, and you're like, I've been doing such great work, I don't understand why I didn't get a higher rating. And that's a tougher conversation to have. That's also a sign of poor management, but you can prevent that. For every competency, you should be talking about what the potential rating would look like, and then have an open conversation of your strengths and your areas of improvement with very specific examples of your work and like what future work that you should be working on to showcase that you are performing well, exceedingly well. You're a superstar. Like, it's all about expectation setting and what your manager needs to see to get you to the next level. So let's talk about that, leveling and promotion. Promotion is not always about the money. It mostly is about the money, but sometimes your level is not high enough to be able to make a transfer in a job ladder. Unfortunately, promotion is kind of a very political process at companies, but the key questions you should be addressing with your manager are, what are your goals when it comes to promotion? Is it to become a manager? Is it to become more senior? Is it money? Is it to transfer job ladders? Then you ask your manager, what is the most realistic trajectory for promotion? So you get a sense of the average and how things normally work. Then you ask, what is the most ideal but feasible trajectory to get you to achieve this goal? Because sometimes managers who are trained in more traditional leadership styles will just slap on an average and be like, sorry, buddy, it's gonna take many years for you to get there no matter what you do, so don't even have these dreams. But that's not you. You're here to transform and skyrocket your career this year, and you gotta ask for it. And I urge you to press them on this. What does the fast track look like? What have other people done before? Because I assure you, there are exceptions. Don't let the average determine your potential. Then ask, how can we put together a career plan to accomplish this goal? What are the milestones and the beats that we need to hit in the next 3 to 6 to 9 months? And this is definitely gonna get your manager's gears going to brainstorm all the different ideas that can help you fast track your career. And it's not like there's a shortcut to it. It's really just focus, just clarity, focus, and expectations. But I have to say, performance and promotion are really complex topics. I actually did a whole video on this when I first started this YouTube channel. It's like one of my earliest videos, so ode to old Chlo. But the key is, you gotta have this conversation with your manager ASAP, like now. Like right now, go schedule this one-on-one with your manager, put it on the calendar. If it's not on the calendar, it's not happening. You know it. But before you go ham on your career, I think that there is some perspective that you should have that can truly be a game changer for you. And I have brought on one of my mentors, Sean Bonowitz, to talk about what advice he would give for people who want to accelerate their careers, like you.
I believe it's far more important and far more valuable to focus on the why, because the how is in the long run the easy part. It really is. What is hard? Why am I doing this? There's surface level answers there. Oh, you want to earn more money, you want to set yourself on this, you know, trajectory to be in a different part of kind of what's going on in the world. Those are all surface level answers. Like, dig deeper into the why. What are you really seeking with more money? What are you really seeking with going from XYZ industry to ABC industry? Dig deeper. What most people find is they don't know why. I've been there many times in the past. I don't know why. And you're just chasing your tail. Today, I know exactly why I'm doing what I'm doing. And figuring out the how is just kind of day to day. But figure out why.
So definitely think about the why, because the why will help you work so much faster, more efficiently, with so much more focus to get you there. But in this video, remember there are three things: your career reflection, performance, and promotion. I'm actually linking this in a Google Doc template for you to make a copy of and like use as your agenda with your one-on-one with your manager. I am so stoked to see you blossoming this year. Like, we are really living the timeline where career isn't bogging you down and you are living your best life. And when you do make it, just don't forget me, okay? I'm your biggest internet cheerleader. And I just want to say one more thing. If you are here watching, it means you're serious, you're motivated, you have what it takes, and you just gotta start now. I know you're meant for this, just like how Elle Woods was meant to be a lawyer. And before you go, I also have my own New Year's announcements. I am officially starting to build a team for Colors of Chloe. What? Crazy. Oh my God. Wow. So if you're interested in this dual professional and creator kind of life, I have a few openings out listed in the description and in my Discord server. So can't wait to be starting up Team Chloe. Yeah. One of the next videos this month is going to be about compensation and breaking that down. It's going to be a big one, so make sure to subscribe and catch that notification. For now, see you all around in the co-working sessions on Twitch and the everyday chat in Discord. Special thanks to the unichlos who have been supporting me throughout this journey, and to Bubbles who have sponsored this video. Thank you. That's all for now. Chloe out.